Okay, we're going to do another example of a splay tree insertion. Remember, in a splay tree, the idea is that the most frequently accessed nodes are supposed to be up at the smaller depth levels. So when we insert a node or we access the node, what we do is we rotate that node all the way up to the root. There are three basic kinds of rotations to worry about. One is if I have the root and the new node that I just inserted is has moved up to the point where it is a child of the root, then I do a single rotation, like so. If, on the other hand, the new node that I've inserted is the grandchild of a node, and I have this out-out kind of construct, this is a zigzag construct, so this edge right here will rotate around that one first, and then we rotate around this edge. So the first rotation around this GP edge gives us PG, with a parent-child relationship like so, dragging along the X, and then I rotate around the PX edge, so I end up with X as the new grandparent, the closer to the root of the tree, and then P and then G. So that'll be my new node, obviously, has moved up to two levels. And then the third kind of rotation I have is when I have a zigzag kind of a construct, like so, where I go in two different directions. And in this case, I just do a regular old AVL double rotation. So first I rotate around the parent and the new node, and then I'll rotate with the grandparent. So the first rotation gives me G remains the same, of course, and then X and P is less than X. So that's the first one I get. And then I rotate around that link right there. So I will end up with X having two children, G and P. Okay, so that's the basic way of doing my rotations. Single rotation when I have the parent of the node is at the root, double rotation for the zigzag, like so, and double rotation for the zigzag.